What's going on? My name is Dmitry, and today I'm going to attempt to transfer guts from BetaFPV Pro2 to Nano X frame. So I've been flying BetaFPV and Nano X for a while now, and I had a lot of fun with it. But I just want to try a very risky, I'm joking of course, a project of transferring guts from this guy to that frame. So we will get something like that and compare how they will fly. For this task, I'm going to use obviously a BetaFPV donor, new frame, extra set of nylon standoffs and nylon screws, as well as some tools I've been using for a while now. Let's start and see how it goes. All right, let's look at our donor for the last time. It's so beautiful, but it's going to be even better. I'm going to use my favorite screwdriver in order to remove all the screws involved in this build. So first we'll start with the motors. We'll remove screw one by one, and once they're all gone, we are going to disconnect the plug from the flight controller. The way I started to do it at first wasn't really correct, and I will tell you how to do it a little bit later. So once motor is gone, we'll just dry fit it and see where it goes. And then once we're sure that it's correct location, we are going to put one screw into the motor halfway in order to be able to securely hold the motor on the frame. So it will simplify our job of screwing other screws into the frame. So we just hold it gently and put all the screws inside. Once it's done, we tighten them down so it will be all securely installed. Then we align it with the frame to see that everything is we wanted it to be, and remove next motor. In this case, I went with the pliers, and I will tell you, don't do it, because you will most likely ruin the wire of the motor. This is what happened to me. I ripped out the wire from the connector. But in all cases, we have to install this motor to the frame. So we repeat the steps exactly the same. We put one screw halfway, and then we install two other screws and tighten them down so it will be all secure and nice. The way you actually remove the connector from the flight controller, you will use flat screwdriver and you will insert it from the side of the battery, from inside, and gently pull the side of the connector away. This way you will be able to remove a wire from the flight controller without any problems. Since I damaged this connector, I'm going to repair it. The way you do it, you lift the lock and you use pliers to pull out the lid from a plastic connector. Once it's out, you slightly open it with the flat screwdriver, and then we are going to solder it all together. So before we can do it, we have to expose the motor wire a little bit and tint it with our soldering iron. So once we have it tinted, we are going to tint the lid, and then we can align wire with the lid and just gently heat, and it will melt together nicely. So once we're done with that, we are going to use pliers and push hooks on the connector, which we previously unlocked, back together in order to make it flat again. Once it's done, we just have to gently push this lid into the connector, and use something, in my case, a screwdriver, to push it completely in. So we did the job. I believe it will work. All right, so we have motors installed, and now we are going to install standoffs. In my case, I'm using 8mm nylon standoffs, but I think 5mm will be just enough. I just didn't have them handy. So the way I do it, I hold the screw with my screwdriver and then gently use my hand in order to complete installation of the standoff. So I'm going just one by one. Once it's all done, we can move to the next step. You see, it is all installed fairly nicely. And now we can grab our donor and use our screwdriver to remove all the screws from the top. In this case, first we remove canopy. Once it's gone, we're going to remove rear screw. And then we're going to remove screw from the camera mount. So flight controller will be completely released and we will pull it out from the frame. Now I'm going to fix the connector on the flight controller, which I previously removed by using pliers, which again you shouldn't do like that and you will be fine. It went in fairly nicely, and now I'm going to remove my old battery connector and reinstall GST connector, simply because most of my batteries, they use GST connector, and I don't have this fancy connector which came with the Beta FPV drone. So first of all, we will tint pads in order to be able to install our new connector. Also make sure you have the connector pre-tinted, and then I am going to face this wire in order to be able to prevent wire getting into the propellers. Again, same idea, you just align a pad with the wire, gently hit it, and it all comes together very nicely. Now we can start with installing it to the frame. You simply align it on top of the standoffs. And then you use this silicone vibration dampeners, I guess it is, and put screw through it and mount flight controller to these standoffs. Once you're done with that, you have to install canopy, and again you put these nuts, I guess, into the flight controller, this sort of sliding, and then you put screws through the canopy and screw them through this setup into the standoff. You may be better off going with standoffs which have screw on top, so you know, like female male kind of one, and then you can use just nuts. I think it will be a bit easier than the way I've done it, but it works, so I don't complain. We have top installed, and now we have to insert our motors back into the flight controller, speed controller board. The best way it is to use your hand. It's the safest way. I was using pliers in order to align connector first, and once it was aligned, I was just pushing them in with my hand. I didn't want to risk and damage wires once again, you know. So once they're all in, we can go and flight test it. You can see everything is in. All looks good, right? No problems. We already have our battery rubber band which will hold it, and that's it. let's take it for a short flight and see how it works. Before that, let's put it to the scales, and it is 29.5 grams. What was the weight before? I don't remember. Might be a bit lighter. Probably standoffs add a bit of extra weight. Okay, let's start flying our Nano X built with BetaFPV guts. The performance is fairly similar to BetaFPV on 1S. It's more like a sluggish whoop type of performance. It flies well in a straight line, and not so much of upward movement with it, unfortunately. So it will be cool to fly it indoor. And again, the same idea as with whoop kind of frames, it bounces back fairly well. Nothing will be damaged with it because of low inertia it has. And yeah, very easy to handle it. And now let's switch to 2S to actually feel more power. It just makes such a huge difference. The response instantly goes maybe even 4 times more than on 1S. Becomes so fast, sort of hard to handle, like after 1S right away. Sorry, my reception is super bad, and it's not like I don't see it well when I fly, it's just DVR records from the weird channel. I don't know why it is like that on Aomway. If you know, maybe let me know so I can actually fix it. I was thinking maybe to flip antennas. But yeah, flies the same, flies really well. So yeah, I think it is a success. Worked exactly as I've expected it, and it wasn't that complicated. Took me maybe just over half an hour, and because I was recording video, so it's just more challenging in general. All right, I hope you had a lot of fun watching this video, at least as much as me creating this video for you. I am all about quality content, so I will appreciate if you will be able to leave a comment below and let me know what do you think about this video. If you have any questions, suggestions, ideas for next videos, I would love to hear it. Please subscribe to my channel, it will help me a lot, it really helps. And I will also leave a few links which will help you, if you liked anything from this, to find where products are located. And see you in the next videos. Bye bye.